ख्याल में आगे मेरे कैमरे
कहाँ तेरा कैमरा कहाँ
एकदम सामने
उनका सेंटर परंतु सेंटर
इस साइड ठेका ही नहीं सर थैंक यू सर
Applause, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, very good, sir. Hi, Farhan. Hi, very good. Now, I'd like to invite, of course, the gentleman here with a really cool beard, if I might add. Ladies and gentlemen, Yash! And the debutante who's been here, by the way, one time, she's been here for a while now, Srinidhi Shetty. And the gentleman who's put this entire epic together from Ombole Films, we've got Mr. Vijay. Vijay, sir, where are you? Please. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, the makers and the cast of this epic called KGF. I'll start with Ritesh first. Ritesh, 2001, the first film that XL did, Dil Chahta Hai, cult, legendary. 17 years, and now it's the beginning of something again where you ventured into a different language. You're presenting a film which was actually originally in a different language. What were the challenges and how excited were you to get on board with this project?
Good afternoon. First of all, sorry we were late. It was some technical stuff which was happening for the trailer. But I think the first step, I don't know where the person is, Mr. India, who's missing today, Anil Thadani, who's the one who first called us up and told us about the film. And the first thing was we watched the movie. And as soon as we saw it, we thought exactly what hopefully you all will feel when you all watch the film, that this team here, which is Vijay with Yash and Prashant, the director, who's also missing today, they had made a wonderful film. And we thought it lent itself to a big screen, like an entertainment, and it seemed like an event film. It was a perfect film for which we thought is the right time if we were trying to look at, you know, expanding the boundaries, going into the regional markets. And I think today we are constantly feeling that, you know, growing our market by going to China and other countries, and, you know, since language is not a barrier for us anymore, and trying to go, why not try to, you know, bring in films and within our own region. So I think that was the first thought. And like I said, it's a great film. It lends itself to a big screen entertainment, so we thought it's the right film to go with.
Farhan, XL, right from the beginning, I've already mentioned the film Dil Chahta Hai, but you've always been at the forefront of content-driven films. Like, you talk of your recent releases like Gold or Fukre, Rais, Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara, Dil Dhadakne Do. Farhan, do you think, as a country now, we keep saying the Indian movie industry, so many different languages, movies are being produced. Do you think as a country now, we have reached that point where the language of the story is not important, but the story in itself?
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think barriers are kind of falling down every single day. The world is becoming a smaller place. We are all enjoying work from cultures and from languages that we weren't very familiar with many years ago. And I think apart from what's happening in film, I think the whole digital revolution has a huge part to play in that, because we're consuming content now, with whether it's subtitled or it's dubbed, you know, in our homes, and we're getting more and more comfortable with just connecting with what it's about, as opposed to finding some amount of resistance because it's not in a language that you're familiar with. So I think that has helped. And eventually, filmmaking is about storytelling, and the story of KGF is very, very strong. It's visually very, very exciting. I've got very inspired. I'm trying to grow my beard like Yash. Hopefully someday I'll get there. But it really is an honor, you know, and when you were calling us up onto stage, I really would like to clarify that Ritesh, me, of course, are presenters for this film. I mean, these people are the makers and the cast, and we're very honored to be a part of it and present it to a Hindi-speaking audience.
Hello, Yash.
Hi.
Been watching a lot of Hindi films lately?
I've been watching since my childhood.
Amazing. And now you have a film which is coming out for this big audience. I was watching an interview recently where you were very clear and you kept saying this, that you are not trying to become a Hindi movie hero, right? But you thought that this film, if it is also in the Hindi language, it reaches a wider audience. If I had to talk of audiences, down in the Kannada film industry and maybe in the Hindi film industry, do you see any difference in the audiences and what they consume?
No, I don't see much of a difference. Audience are same everywhere. They're very honest. If they like something, they like it, irrespective of your previous records. If they don't like, they'll kick you out of theater. They're very honest. I think it's same everywhere.
Srinidhi.
Hi.
She's got a story, man. From the field of engineering to a corporate job with a company called Accenture to now making it here in the movies. I mean, where did the switch happen? You've been into pageants also, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah. So the desire to be part of this industry, entertainment industry, was there since my childhood. It's just that parents were very strict enough that you have to finish your education and you have to do something which they seem is right.
Been there.
So yeah. So for their happiness, I was like, chalo karte kuch, so engineering kiya and then get into a corporate company. But then I made sure that, you know, try getting out somehow, and then sneaked into modeling, and now I'm here by God's grace.
No, sir. Okay. Very simple. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think we should now show the trailer to this wonderful media that is present here, and of course they've all got their cameras out. So if you could take your seats, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so this is chapter one, which means it's a two-part epic. So I'm sure we have questions, but I'll start with Yash first. I have a question to ask. Yash, it doesn't look like a film that would have been easy while shooting, right? Especially sure. During, you know, the mining shots that you must have definitely shot for. How difficult was it on set to just be there around all this muck that is flying around, man?
It was very difficult. That was the most difficult part of the film. Because that's a processed sand, processed soil. They use, cyanide to process gold, I believe. So that was the dump yard of that. And a lot of people told us it is not safe to shoot there. But still, it was very tempting for us to shoot because the location was as such. It was very... very nice, suitable for our film. Then we went there and we all stayed there for months together. And then for every shot, if you notice, there's a lot of dust in it. And we didn't get artificial dust. It was using, we used compressor and it was the same thing. So, but we were very strong and because of the conviction, I think nothing happened.
Farhan, there is a part of the underworld also, and I remember that interview where Yash mentioned that this is not just about the underworld, this is not just about, but somehow the underworld has always been a great content idea for a lot of films, right? Do you, when you were watching the trailer while everybody else was watching it, do you think the underworld is something which elicits emotion when it comes to the content of a film?
No, I mean, you know, I really don't think of it as in that terms. I feel with every film, there's a certain USP, there's a certain draw. And in this film, like I said, the story of this one character, what he's out to achieve, is very, very strong. You get a sense of almost like a promise that this child is making his mother in the beginning of the film, of what he's going to be and what he's going to do. And it really follows his journey and his path. And that is really something that drives the film. So everything else that comes with it is actually from a place which is of pure emotion and of pure love. So that's it. That to me is the driving force of the film. Everything else, I mean, of course, is a lot of fun to watch. Like you can see, there's amazing action going on. There's a lot of humor in it as well. There's that one moment where he breaks this guy's arm and then uses his arm to push his hair back. So things like that. It's got all that going on, but at the heart of it, there's a very, very strong emotional connect that this character has with this promise that he's made his mother.
All right, my friends from the media, I'm sure you have questions, so please, this is your opportunity. Shoot. There's this one lady who is just interested in taking a picture.
Center, sir. Rahul, the filmy sister. Hello. मेरा सवाल फरहान सर से है. Sir, South की लगभग सारी फिल्में अपनी जगह blockbuster होती है, sir. सब में content होते हैं. टर्न एंड ट्विस्ट होते हैं फिर उन सारी फिल्मों में से KGF को चुनना हिंदी में डब करना फिर रिलीज करना तो आपने KGF को ही क्यों चुना क्या ऐसा लगा इसका
सर एक तो मैं आपको थोड़ा क्लैरिटी दे दूं कि कभी कभी होता है कि आप स्क्रिप्ट चुनते हैं कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि फिल्म आपको चुनती है तो इसमें जो हुआ है एक्चुअली जो अनिल थडानी जो आज यहाँ आई डोंट नो वेयर ही इज बट उन्होंने हमें कॉन्टैक्ट किया कहा कि एक फिल्म है आप देख लीजिए मुझे लगता है आपको पसंद आएगी और अगर पसंद आई तो we would like for you to present it. So both Ritesh and me saw some visuals from the film, we found out about the film, and it sounded like a very, very exciting project to be part of. And all I can say is that we are truly happy that we associated with this film. And this probably then is a first step, you know, hopefully through this experience, there will be more people who want to reach out to us and maybe get their films presented. And that will be based on each film as it comes and what we feel of that film. With this film, it felt like the right thing to do, and that's why we're here today.
Hi, this is Sohail here on your left. You're on the first row. Congratulations to the entire team of KGF. Farhan, hum aapko miss kar rahe hain on the screen as well as direction-wise. Soon we'll see you actually. Mera kehna tha ke in dino, lots of production houses are, you know, looking towards South actually. Jis tarah ki film hai, matlab hai, Hindi mein dub ho rahi hai. How do you see the entire scenario at this point, particular point of time?
Sir, आपका सवाल किसकी तरफ है?
आपकी तरफ या
फरहान की तरफ?
हाँ यार, you know it's very difficult for me to comment on why other people do things they do. I just feel that at XL for the last 17-18 years we've been making films that we believe in. And similarly, as an extension of that, when there is something that we can associate ourselves with, that we feel would be a pleasure to associate with. It's some entertainment that we can provide an audience or help reach an audience. That is something that we're interested in. We want to entertain people. We want to engage with people through film. And this is another opportunity to do that. I don't look at it as south, north, east, west. I don't think of it like that. Movies and storytelling, like we discussed earlier, it's changing. The demographics of audiences are changing. The way content is consumed is changing. And we are at a very interesting time, you know, where we are fortunate that we can share each other's work in each other's states or cultures or in different regions. And to be a part of that truly is a very, it's an honor actually to be a part of it.
There was a question coming.
Yash,
yes.
Yash, my question to you. Yash. Mike,
Yash. Yash,
hi.
Yeah. Have you dubbed it in Hindi?
No, I haven't. I think I still have to work on my Hindi because just to prove that I'm a hard-working actor, if I go and dub, I don't want to ruin my film because I really love my film. But soon I'll be able to dub because I think a lot of people are, you know, telling my Hindi is improving. So very soon I'll be there.
I agree with
that. Do you like someone else mouthing your dialogues?
To be honest with you, no. As an actor, I would always want to dub for my own films. But I think nobody is bigger than cinema. When it comes to cinema, the cinema has to come out well. It has to do well. It has to entertain people. So if I come out and start dubbing in a bad Hindi, that will hamper the movie. So which I don't want it to happen.
Varun, my question to you is, we've been seeing you producing films and associating. When will we see you acting and directing as well? Very soon?
I'm just finishing a film with Sonali Bose called The Sky is Pink. It's almost done. So you'll see that at some point mid next year. And beyond that, we'll discuss on some other forum. Right now, we are here to talk about KGF, if that's okay with you. Yeah.
Farhan, towards your left, in the front row. Hi.
Front row.
This is Priyanka from PTI. Farhan, I wanted to know that, a lot of these South filmmakers have great vision, and the way they tell their story, it's always on a huge canvas. Be it this, be it KGF, be it Bahubali or 2.0 as well. But when it comes to Bollywood filmmakers, I feel that, we don't have that vision. And what stops us from dreaming big or planning big? That's something I wanted to know from you.
I don't know if that's entirely true. I mean, you've taken the name of three films. I'm sure there are many other films made in the South that we are not aware of or are smaller in terms of drama films or intimate films or personal films. These are the ones that excite people across the country to maybe want to watch because of the visual scale, of them. And similarly, I mean, we have filmmakers. I think somebody like Sanjay Leela Bhansali, for example, is somebody who makes very, very epic visual films. So we do have filmmakers like that, but every industry and every, culture has its own strengths, and it's important to play to those strengths, and you will learn as you go along and you will evolve. But I think that's really what it is, and the ones that translate, similarly with American films, when they come here, the ones that usually end up registering are the big, kind of superhero movies or stuff like that, because it's easier for people to go and understand what's going on. I think that's probably it.
Hello. Yash?
Which side, sir? If you could just raise your hand.
Right side.
There, okay.
Hi, Yash. Many, many congratulations for Baby Girl.
Okay, thank you very much.
यश हमने देखा था कि बाहुबली दो चैप्टर्स में बने हुए हैं तो फर्स्ट चैप्टर जब ख़त्म होता है तो सभी के दिमाग में ये सवाल आता है कि कटप्पा ने बाहुबली को क्यों मारा उसी तरह चैप्टर वन में भी क्या ऐसा ही कुछ होगा जो दूसरी फिल्म की तरफ हमें ले जाएगा
आर यू किलिंग समवन एट द एंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर
नो ऐसे उस वजह से फिल्म चली वो नहीं कह सकते एंड इवन आई डोंट थिंक डायरेक्टर वुड हैव डिपेंडेड ऑन दैट वन पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट अगर फिल्म अच्छी है तो चलेगी और लास्ट में ऑफकोर्स यस वी हैव टू हैव समथिंग विच विल यू नो गेट द ऑडियंस फॉर द सेकेंड पार्ट वैसे है हर सीरीज पे सीरियल में भी होता है नेक्स्ट एपिसोड देखने के लिए वैसा ही कुछ करना पड़ता है ऑडियंस को सो इन दिस फिल्म ऑल्सो देर इज समथिंग लाइक दैट बट आई कैन नॉट कंपेयर इट टू कटप्पा बिकॉज देर इज नो कटप्पा इन अवर फिल्म
Okay.
One question. Since we're talking of the chapter, right, the first chapter, is there a question on how much time should pass after the first chapter that the second chapter should release? Like, is there ever a time like that? Okay, we have to release it.
No. See, nothing goes according to the plan in cinema. Even our first part has taken much more time than what we expected. So I don't know. It all depends on my director, who is missing today. He is a perfectionist. He's a wonderful director. It's all his work. He's missing today. In Bombay, it's me who is coming and talking about on behalf of him. But I think he's the man who has created this, Mr. Prashant Neel. He takes its own time. He takes his own sweet time. Even today he was supposed to come, but he's still working on the film. He says, it's your this thing. Please, you take care of that responsibility. I'll work. I'll make it better. So I cannot tell you that how much time we'll take, but we want to come very soon because everything is ready. The script is ready. We just have to go there, shoot, and come and release.